So I think if we look at the affected areas in West Africa, the risk of Ebola showing up in Canada is relatively low. You know, there's about 1.5% of all of the international air traffic from those areas comes to Canada. You know, like in so many other areas, the best defense is a really good offense. And in this situation, controlling the outbreak at its source is the most effective way to minimize the risks to other countries like Canada. There aren't a lot of tools that are rapidly available to do quick risk assessments of how this disease might spread to other parts of the world. This is one of the reasons that post-SARS here in Toronto, I started to develop with my colleagues here a tool we call Biodiaspora, and it's basically a system that looks at the movements of commercial flights and people worldwide and integrates this with other forms of big data to try and better anticipate risks in other parts of the globe. This is not a disease that you acquire by walking by someone who's infected. This is a disease that's transmitted by direct contact with blood or body fluids of someone who's actually sick with Ebola. So the risk really is to healthcare providers on the front lines, not to the average person in the general public.